You're now asked to figure out what date has no calls or SMSs. Now this is a bit of a trick question and you have to trick Excel into doing it. So first let's empty our pivot, so we've got nothing here. So it says what date has no calls or SMSs, so it looks like I need to put the date down here. Again, I'm just going to ungroup it and remove this graph. Now what you'll see is it just lists the dates it can find. Now if you're very diligent, you may notice that there's a 28th of January and there's a 30th of January, so somehow it's missed 29th of January. So I suppose you could do it that way, but we're going to try and trick Excel into giving us an answer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take perhaps duration and put it into values, and I'm going to do a count. So again, so this is giving us an answer, but again it's very difficult to spot. So what you can do is you're going to right click and group this, and we're going to tell it to group it in days. I'm going to remove the months, and the number of days is going to be a 1. So when I say OK, you'll see it gives us the days, but it hasn't really done anything yet. We've still got this problem here. What I now do is I right click and I go to field settings, and you'll see under layout and print it says an item here saying show items with no data. So when I click on that and I say OK, you'll see it does a couple of things. Firstly, it does start at the beginning of the year, even though our data only starts here. But when I scroll down, you'll notice that it now goes in sequence. So the 29th of Jan is shown here, but you'll see it's got a gap. So you'll see that we can clearly see now where the gaps are. But as you've noticed, we've had to trick Excel into doing this.